Hi friends, welcome to Aerotech Solutions. I just want to give embedded system introduction. So this is one of the best option for electronics engineers nowadays. This is a very important field or very good choice for the electronics engineers who wants to come into core side. So embedded system is one field. There are even other systems. I'll give a simple definition for system. Basically, every electronic system is integrated or combined with two components, which are hardware and software combination. But if you want to give perfect definition for embedded system, what is hardware involved in embedded and what is software involved in embedded, so you want to know the differences. Basically, electronic system is a combination of inputs and outputs. Most of the cases, you are dealing with different inputs and different outputs for your system. As inputs, what you are noticing from electronics products, so right from simple calculated to industry level product, you are finding different kinds of inputs and you are finding different kinds of outputs. So as inputs, most of the cases you are using switches or buttons, and the other option is keyboards or keypads, and sometimes you may use sensors, and sometimes you may use card readers, and sometimes you are using modems. So these are the different options for the electronics applications. And coming to outputs, you are noticing that every system will contain one display unit. So as display, again you are noticing different options. Maybe basic indicators. Indicators means a simple LEDs. And for numeric displays, most of the cases you are going to deal with the 7 segments and LCDs. And other option is graphical LCDs, and the other option is TFT screens, which is touch screens. So these are the different display units you may find from the products as display. And otherwise, you are finding some audio videos, audio video output from the products, which are most of the cases in entertainment and application level. Audio video is also one of the output option for your product. And electrical loads. So electrical loads may be single phase or three phase, so which are used by industries most of the cases. Every product which may contain one of the output unit, which is a single phase or three phase electrical loads. Sometimes you may find motors. Again, motors are different types: DC, stepper, servo. These are all different types of motors you may find from the robotics field. And the other option is modem, because you can use modems even in input side and as well as output side. So this is a simple system. You may notice that it is a combination of different inputs and different outputs. Whenever you are looking to design this kind of electronic system, so what is the field or what is the platform you can choose, and what's happening with your system generally? So your system responsibility is very clear. It has to take the input from your device, whatever you connected across here, and it has to control your output device. Suppose I am giving one pulse from the sensor, it has to take this input. And for based on sensor, you have to take a particular action on your output device. Maybe controlling motor, maybe giving audio or video output, or showing text on screens, or else controlling motors. It may be different requirement you are expecting from the application. Who will take care of your input from the device and how it controls your output device? So further, you need to deal with one programmable device. See, what is the meaning of programmable device in electronic systems? So there are many components you may find from hardware point of view in electronics. So particularly you are noticing that resistors, capacitors, integrated circuits and different components in a board. It may be calculator board, or it may be TV board, or it may be mobile board, or any product you are just opening that, you may find different hardware components. But from among these different hardware components, You need to search for this programmable device. Every system is going to use one programmable device compulsory. So, as an electronic student, you are aware of these programmable devices names. So, processors, controllers, and digital signal processors, which are named as DSP, and field programmable gate arrays, which are FPGAs and PLCs. So every system will use any one of these programmable device compulsory based on the product expected output. Okay, so sometimes people will use PLCs for industry kind of products. Sometimes they will use processors or controllers for all consumer level products or entertainment products or defense products or robotics. So wherever you can watch the motherboard of your device or product. So as a programmable device, most of the cases you are finding these processor controllers. Then you are finding digital signal processors in such applications like digital cameras, which are related to image processing, speech processing or voice processing. So in such applications, they are going to use these DSP processors. And FPGAs, which are field programmable gate arrays. So these are also used in applications. And PLCs, which are programmable logic controllers, used by most of the industries like cement industries, pharma industries. So they will deal with more number of IOs, which are in hundreds. But they will prefer PLCs. But every system will contain one programmable device compulsory. So this is the only device, it will take care of your input and controlling your output device. How it is going to control? So how it will consider your input and how it controls your output device? So that purely based on your programming means you need to talk with this device by using a standard programming languages. So as an engineer, you should tell to the device, so take the input and control your output. So these programmable devices have different, these programmable languages are different for your different devices. Coming to processors and controllers, so you are using assembly, which is come with our academic initially, and C or C++. Nowadays people are using this Python even for applications, especially for processors and controllers. And coming to this digital signal processors, they are using MATLAB is a programming language. And for your FPGAs, they are using Verilog or VHDL. And for PLCs, they are using ladder logics. So this is where the standard definition hardware and software is involved here. Means every system will contain essentially programmable devices, and these devices are following standard programming languages. You cannot proceed by learning Verilog or VHDL with PLCs. By learning MATLAB, you cannot proceed with PLCs. So if you want to work with this process and controllers, so as a programmer or as a person, you should learn C, C++ or Python, which are used by the industries. Okay, so if you are looking to work with these programmable devices, it is compulsory to learn these programming languages. So this is where people are telling that the standard definition hardware and software combination is electronic system. So if you want to justify this, I'll give you a simple equation. So basically your hardware software combination is electronic system initially. So based on hardware category, so which means from hardware you need to focus on programmable device the major important device. Then what about the other hardware? See, don't think that the resistors or capacitors and all other components are not coming to hardware point. Yes, so those components are also very important for us. But programmable device is mandatory for your system, which will accept your program with a standard language. So without writing program, your device is not going to take any action itself. Okay, so your programmable device will act as a brain for your system, so that you have to focus on this programmable device in every system. Okay, so you have to focus on hardware. Like if you are using processors and controllers as programmable devices, So what is the language you should learn compulsory to deal with these processors and controllers? Which is C, which is embedded C, or C++, or advanced C, or Python. So this combination we'll call it as everything is system. Okay, so but when the product which is comes under embedded category, as a person, whenever you are using these processors and controllers as a programmable device, and your program should be developed with C, embedded C, or C++, then this electronic system is comes under the category of embedded system. Okay, and when the product which is comes under VLSI system, so if you are using FPGA is a programmable device and Verilog or VHDL is a language. So based on this criteria, your system which is comes under VLSI category. So every system will contains these two points, which is hardware and software. You want to become embedded engineer, then proceed with these processors and controllers and C or C++. Then you will become a person into embedded domain. And you want to become a VLSI engineer, you concentrate on programmable device which is FPGA and programming languages Verilog or VHDL. So this will make you perfect person in the domain. Okay, so then the other category is DSP system. Even there is another domain which is DSP. So here you need to focus on digital signal processors knowledge and MATLAB programming language. So this will make you perfect person in the specific category, which is DSP. And you want to become a person in automation category, so you should focus on programmable logic controllers and ladder logics. So this is a simple view of core engineers who wants to become so and so person in the specific domains. Please focus on programmable devices and programming languages. So this will make you a perfect person in the specific domain. You want to become embedded engineer, please concentrate on process controllers knowledge and programming languages C, C++ and embedded C. And you want to become VLSI engineer, concentrate on FPGA device knowledge and Verilog VHDL programming skills. And you want to become DSP engineer, concentrate on digital signal processors knowledge and MATLAB programming language. You want to become automation engineer, concentrate on PLCs and ladder logics programming language. This is how people will go for different areas, and every domain has its own strength in the market, and there are good openings with the individual domains. Even there are a good vast space for the engineers in VLSI, embedded, automation and DSP. Because in our day-to-day life, everything which is converted into electronic system for every individual work, suppose if you want to do any work, just mention the work, I find one electronic system for that. So if you want to design such kind of electronic systems with a combination of different inputs and different outputs categories, you have to choose any one of these domain for you. Okay, so here, but system is, it is a calculator, or it is a computer, or it is a mobile phone, or it is a washing machine, or it is an ATM machine, or it is a defense system, or it is a transport system, every medical product. If you take everything which is a combination of sensors and displays, or keypads with displays, or sensors with audio video, see, every product is combination any one of this input and any one of this output, or multiple inputs and multiple outputs. And who is going to take care of your inputs and outputs control in a system? Your programmable devices. So particularly why I'm calling these are programmable devices, because this is the only device which will accept your instructions, or which accepts your commands, which accepts your program. Your resistor is not take care of your command, your capacitor is not executing your program. Okay, so this is the only reason you need to take out one programmable device compulsory for every simple product, or it is an industry product, or it is any kind of product, you have to take care of this. So this is how you need to manage your hardware knowledge, you need to manage your programming skills. So as a person, you have to concentrate on both compulsory, and don't keep it in mind, if you are expert in hardware, you can become an engineer. So if you want to become a complete person in a domain, so you should focus on two skills, programming skills and programmable devices, along with one operating system. So my suggestion is, if you want to become one engineer in a domain, so you should very keen about one programmable device knowledge, one programming language knowledge with one operating system. So even companies may ask Windows and Linux persons individually, so that your operating system is also matters. So on which kind of operating system you learn from academic level. Suppose if you have skills on only Windows operating system in your computers, so you should upgrade your skills even from operating system side, which is Linux. Thank you.